also there's an agenda, so if anybody wants to follow along, I know some people like to see the agendas, and we're going to keep to our schedule just so we can get through all the fun events that we have working. So to kick it off, I think we are connecting and conversing. Each of the table hosts has some questions and activities that we're going to be discussing, so yes, let's start. Before we let the games begin.
Yeah. I Yeah. I used to be, thankfully, but I used to be. Yeah.
Thank you. had about 15 minutes left.
Thank you.
got 5 more minutes. It's like you guys are having some great conversation.
Thank you. Thank you. There's one with a hot dog in it.
Excuse. So it was really good.
And we're going to talk a little bit about why, and which is, man, they really did it up. Look, wonder, hope, yearn. So in case you have no idea what we're talking about, you can just look at the wall. And we all ask why. And sometimes it's a, you know, type of why. And other times it's a, why? Which is usually me. And kids. Now, you may all not be mothers in here, but I'm sure you either have a niece, a nephew, or you babysat children. After, you know, mama, dada, Starbucks. Literally, I was in Target. It was like 2 years old. Starbucks. Starbucks. Man, training that child right. But, you know, why? No, that's the first thing. Why? You say, you need to eat your vegetables. Why? Because you need to put good things in your body. Why? Because good things in our body gives us energy. Why? Because that's how our bodies work. Why? Because that's the way God made our bodies. Why? Then you say, I don't know. You'll have to ask God. Why? And in that moment, you have a choice. You can either continue this conversation for the next 20 minutes or 20 years. Or you can give that child the answer that you said you would never give any child because you hated it when you were little. And what is that? Because I said so. But here's the trick. When you say that, no eye contact and walk away quickly. Yeah, do not engage, because then it just starts all over again. When my boys were young, they used to, you know, ask why a lot. Why? How come he gets to go there? And how come he gets to do that? Why? And I said, well, I can either be fair or I can be just. And they're thinking, okay. I said, if I'm fair, you're both going to get the same thing. You're going to get a size 11 pair of tennis shoes, and you're going to get a pair of size 11 tennis shoes. And I, or I can be just, and you can have what you need. Not necessarily what you deserve, but what you need. And so, you know, they kind of thought about that a little bit. And as the boys grew and life kind of happened, you know, life happens. Life makes you crazy. And there are so many things that keep me up at night. And I know you're probably thinking, how to cure homelessness, hunger crisis in third world countries. No, that is not what I think about. I think about why. Why are all of the seasonal products in the far back corner of Target? I just want a bag of candy corn. But no, I have to go through the entire store. Now I know why they do it, because they know that from the front door to the candy corn, I'm gonna find 7 things I cannot live without. So, why are there no B batteries? Why can't women put on mascara with their mouth closed? Try it. Next time you put on some mascara. Why is a carrot more orange than an orange? And if we call it an orange, why don't we call a lemon a yellow and a lime a green? Probably because if a waiter walked up to you and said, excuse me, would you like some yellow in your water? You would probably say, I'm good. No, yeah, I'm gonna pass on that one. Why doesn't Tarzan have a beard? home Sundays. Why don't they come Tuesdays? I like a Tuesday with a little bit of extra fudge. Why do they call it an Adam's apple? If that's the case, we should call these Eve's hips. Because I can guarantee you, this is definitely the result of the fall. Why can a man hear a twig snap 300 yards in the woods? But when he is standing next to any female, this is what he hears. Why can skating on thin ice get you into hot water? We have created this whole different language in our society today, and I'm not talking about Pastor Jerryisms, because they actually make sense. Gooder means it's just gooder. Cheering are those things that cost you a lot of money and annoy you. Like the word diet. The trend now is to call it anything but that. There are meal plans. Nutrition therapy. Lifestyle change. Health management system. And probably the reason why all of the marketing has done that is because die, D-I-E, are the first three letters in the word diet. I don't want to do that. And why do they call it losing weight? It's not like I want to find it again. I want it gone. I want to shed it. I want it forever. I don't want to lose it. And I work in Nevada State College. I work with mostly young people. I never know what they're talking about. And they stand kind of in the cafeteria and they talk, and the other day somebody said, they're like, oh man, she is just ratchet. And I was like, am I, is something broken? Do we need to go get a toolbox? No, that means that they're like obnoxious. And then the other one was just like, they're like, oh, that's Gucci. I'm like, how in the world does a Nevada State College student afford Gucci? But that means that it's like good or chill or fresh. The other day, somebody said, keep it 100. I thought, wow, man, that is awesome that they did that grade on an exam. And they're like, oh, no, that's like keeping it real. It's like, yeah. And the other, these two girls, they were talking to each other, and the one said, like, oh, that's fetch. She said, are you sure it's not OTT? I'm like, what in the world is going on? Fetch means cool, good. OTT is over the top. Like, how hard is it? You look really nice tonight. Are you sure it's not too much? No one can do that anymore. And just when I got used to FOMO, fear of missing out, now there's JOMO, which is the joy of missing out because you're glad that you didn't have to go to that event. Yeah, FOMO, JOMO, who knows? I'm just saying, you know, we could probably save a lot in our education if in kindergarten we just did this. Hey, today class, these are 26 letters. It's called the alphabet. You can assign any words you want to any one of these letters. String them together any way you prefer, and basically that will become your language. So, we were gonna spend 25 minutes on this, but it only took about 30 seconds, so everybody gets to go to recess. It's crazy. So, workplace is a whole nother why. My grandmother used to say, mean what you say and say what you mean. Not happening today. When they say, please tell me what you think, it really means fix this chaos that you have created. time, please do it this way. Means, don't ever do that again. You spelled a few things wrong in this paragraph, could have been a little better. You have to do the entire thing from scratch now. You know, I'm really overwhelmed right now. Means, I really don't want to help you. Moms? Moms are the worst. We say, we'll see. Actually, it's not likely, quit asking. We say, no, we are not there yet. We mean, ask again, I will tie you to the roof racks. We say, want to play with my iPhone? We mean, if I give this to you, will you please let me drink this cup of coffee? We look at our child and we say, are you sure about that? We really mean, you are wrong and delusional. Rethink whatever you said or did. And when we're absolutely quiet, just contemplative, it's, you better run, you better run. Stop speaking to me this moment. Now church, that's a whole nother ball game. It would be really great if, you know, my husband and I used to pastor in Boulder City, and it would have been really great if somebody, when we asked them, if they just would have said, no, I can't, or I'm sorry. Even if they said, no, I don't want to, I would have preferred that. But in the church, we kind of find a way to make everything spiritual. Yeah, and if we can sound more spiritual, even better, because then you don't feel bad. So when someone says, I'll pray about it, that's a hard no. Oh, that's not my calling. I can do it, I just don't want to. Oh, I don't want to rob them of their blessing. I want to go home and take a nap. God is leading me in a different direction. And that would be to Starbucks and the mall. The Lord talked to me and he said, no. Don't stand next to that person. Because they really like to live dangerously. I just don't feel led by the Spirit. That sounds like too much work. And my favorite, God is telling me to rest now.
Yes.
Which means, no, I will not work in the nursery. I went to a conference a couple years ago, and the woman was speaking, and it's just kind of the same concept, why, and this friend of mine, who's no longer a friend of mine because she did this to me, went to the speaker and said, you need to talk to my friend. You really need to talk to my friend. So we were all done. The speaker came up to me. She goes, hi, I understand, you know, you'd like to talk to me. I said, no, I'm good. Yeah. Must have been some misunderstanding. And she said, no, I really think I'm supposed to talk to you. I'm like, okay. And I was going through a lot, and I was really angry at God, and just a lot was going on, and she looked at me, and she said, Lynn, you're eating from the wrong tree. And I thought, I'm like, well, you don't have that great of a figure either, lady, so I'm like, yeah, you don't need to call me out on it. And I'm like, okay, explain, you know, my own bite. And she said, you need to stop eating from the why tree, and you need to start eating from the what tree. The why tree will only make you frustrated. And even if you get the answers you want, you're still never going to be satisfied. But the what tree asks you, what do you want me to learn through this season? What am I supposed to be hearing? What am I supposed to be doing? I would like to say that magically that night, I transformed. It was 3 years ago, and I have not. I still ask why a lot. I still get frustrated a lot. But I want to close with this. This is a verse in Proverbs 2, 6 through 11. For the Lord grants wisdom. From his mouth came knowledge and understanding. He grants a treasure of common sense to the honest. He is a shield to those who walk with integrity. He guards the path of the just and protects those who are faithful to him. Then you will understand what is right, just, and fair, and you will find the right way to go. For wisdom will enter your heart, and knowledge will fill you with joy. Wise choices will watch over you, and understanding will keep you safe. So, it's been fun, ladies. I hope you guys all are able to come back tomorrow. I know some of you can't, but so thrilled to have our guests from Arizona. And I know, I keep on wanting to say Shawnee, but you said Sean.
I saw it.
I know. I think I just need to call you a different name, like Betty or something.
Yeah. Okay.
In closing, I just wanted to go over some of the agenda items. Yesterday, I did notice that
the laser's more
during the lunch break, it's at 12, not 2. If there was a one got removed. So it says from 2 to 1. It's actually from 12 to 1. So just if anybody had questions, we're not doing lunch backwards. Not losing an hour somewhere. It's at 12 tomorrow. And then also just to go over, letting you guys know, the doors will open at 9. We will have coffee and continental breakfast at from 9 to 9:30, and then we'll start worship at 9:30.
Fill the screen.
Prayer. Opening. Welcome prayer. And then worship. Yes. So I just wanted to thank everybody tonight for coming and fellowshipping. And we're super excited about what tomorrow's going to bring in answering our why for each one of us. And if anybody fill out any of their question cards yet? If not, tomorrow by lunchtime. One more time. Please. So if anybody has any questions that they want answered tomorrow, please feel free. I'll have a basket sitting out there at the welcome desk. As soon as I'm done here. Thank you all for coming. It was a great time seeing all of you, so many of you, and I look forward to seeing you guys all tomorrow morning.
Yeah.